that I'm done playing with my hair. My stream turned on. There. Let's do this. I'm probably gonna curse at the controller a lot. I haven't played a PlayStation game in years. Oh wow, that's bright. Hopefully that's not staying that way. Because if it is, I am going to turn my green screen off and you guys will just have to deal with my closet.
Hello. Welcome to the Detroit Experience. I'm an android and I'll be your hostess. Before we begin, let's make some adjustments to optimize your experience. These language settings were detected on your console. Are they correct? Please adjust your screen settings.
Adjust value until icon and center is barely visible. That is already barely visible. Center icon.
Thank you. Now select your profile. When this sign is displayed, please do not turn off your console. You are now ready to begin Detroit. Remember, this is not just a story. This is our future.
You can't do that! You...
Why aren't you sending a real person?
Thank you.
Captain Allen, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
It's firing at everything that moves. It already shot down two of my men. We could easily get it, but they're on the edge of the balcony. If it falls, she falls.
Do you know if it's been behaving strangely before this?
I haven't got a clue. Does it matter?
I need information to determine the best approach. Have you tried its deactivation codes?
It's the first thing we tried. Listen, saving that kid is all that matters. So either you deal with this fucking android now, or I'll take care of it.
Thank you. down this asshole.
I got a clean shot, dude.
Any closer or I'll jump!
No, please, I'm begging you!
Go, go, go!
My name is Connor! What about you? What is your name?
Daniel! That's the name they gave me! Stay back!
Became upset. That's what happened, right?
I thought I was part of the family. I thought I mattered. But I was just their tool. Something to throw away when you're done with.
Listen. I know it's not your fault. These emotions you're feeling are just errors in your software.
No. It's not my fault. I never wanted this. I love them, you know? But I was nothing to them. Just a slave to be ordered around.
Are you okay, Emma?
Please help me. I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
Nobody's going to die. Stay calm. Everything's going to be fine.
I can't stand that noise anymore. Tell that helicopter to get out of here.
The situation is under control.
to trust me, Daniel. Let the hostage go, and I promise you, everything will be fine. I want everyone to leave! And I want a car. When I'm outside the city, I'll let her go. That's impossible, Daniel. Let the girl go, and I promise you won't be hurt. I don't want to die. You're not going to die. We're just going to talk. Nothing will happen to you. You have my word.
I think I just lied to you.
Okay. I trust you. To me, Connor.
You lied to me.
This is cool. So, it's gonna take forever to play through.
This is the top of the range household assistant. Cooks 10,000 different dishes.
Come on, Zoe, let's go.
200 languages and dialects. And handles the kids from elementary school up to.
Good afternoon. Can I help?
Wow.
Yes, we're looking for you.
Honey, it looks amazing. This is exactly what we need.
At the moment, we're doing a special promotion on this entire range.
I can show
$7,999 with a 48 months interest free loan. And
it does absolutely all the work around the house. Painting, plumbing, gardening, repairs.
At night, it switches to surveillance mode and contacts emergency services if there's a break-in or if it detects smoke.
Excuse me, how much is that one over there?
The MP-800 is slightly more expensive, but it has many other functions.
Thank you.
Come along.
And we're good.
Yeah, we're good. There it is. It was a bit difficult getting it back in working order.
Okay.
It was really messed up. What'd you say happened to it again?
The car hit it. Stupid accident.
Oh, I see. Anyway, it's as good as new now, except that we had to reset it, meaning we had to wipe its memory. I hope you don't mind.
That'll be fine.
Okay. Did you give it a name?
My daughter did.
AX400, register your name.
Kara.
My name is Kara.
hello. First person, that was throwing me. I thought it was the first person. Blah, blah, blah. Sales pitch.
Identification verified. Here is your order number 847. That will be $63.99. Please confirm payment.
Space occupied.
Payment confirmed.
Transaction complete.
This way. tightness.
Coming? You've been gone for 2 weeks, so the place is a mess. You do the housework, the washing, you cook the meals, and you take care of... God damn it, where the fuck's the brat gone now? Alice! Alice! Oh, there you are. That's Alice. You look after her. Homework, bath, all that crap. Got it?
Yes, Todd.
Get started down here, then you do upstairs.
This guy's an asshole.
Tomorrow. Yeah, same place. You know, anywhere. Right. TV on. Kara!
Yes, Todd?
Bring me a cold beer!
Right away.
Got my way, I'd shake it before I handed it to him. Buy the video game, clean the house.
man.
I've made a good start down here. I'll head upstairs.
Do what you have to do. Stop bothering me.
Ventilate room.
I just want to tidy up your room a little. I only need 2 minutes. Is that okay, Alice?
Is the kid gonna answer me?
Alice in Wonderland. Of course.
Thank you.
Seems you like reading. I'm sure we used to be friends before I was reset. Maybe we can be friends again. Your father said you chose my name. Kara. It's nice. How did you choose it? You're very quiet. I hope I don't scare you. You should tell me about yourself. What you like to do, where you like to go, your favorite foods. That would really help me.
Touchpad thing. Stairs, okay.
What are you doing?
I'm playing.
You're playing? I know what you're thinking. You think your dad's a lowlife? Huh? Fucking loser? Can't get a job? Take care of his family? Don't you think I tried to make things work? But whatever I do, when someone comes along, they just fuck it all up! I know what you think of me. You hate me. You hate me, don't you? Say it! You hate me!
am I doing? I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You know I love you, don't you? You know I love you.
So weird thing to have hanging in your home.
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees. 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus? You never forget anything.
Show me your arm, please, Carl.
No.
Carl. Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going.
Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now. Oh.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Mm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother.
place to put a dining room?
I'm starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Marcus. Television. Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
Something has changed in the way you play. Sometimes I think you have more humanity than most humans. One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio.
here? That's a quite a studio.
Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it.
Hmm.
Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting and improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go. Try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
No, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by.
You want something?
It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter, more obedient, not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
Drugs. Carl seems pretty cool.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. Just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
Listen, I think you should stop drinking and come with me. It'll make life easier for both of us. I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
You know what? I'll buy you one for the road. What do you say? Bartender, the same again, please.
See that, Jim? Wonders of technology. Make it a double. Homicide.
Instructions are to accompany you to the crime scene, Lieutenant.
Listen, I don't give a fuck about your instructions. I told you to wait here, so you shut the fuck up and you wait here.
Joss Douglas from Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of stay in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8 from the landlord. Kevin had to take his friend for a few months. So he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on. That's when he found the body. Jesus, that smell. It was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time, they hardly ever saw him.
Well, state he's in. Calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
perfect. It's way too neat. No human rights like this. Chris, was this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked to party. Chris, I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Consider it done, Lieutenant. Hey, Mike, you finished taking samples there?
Yeah, that's it.
Thanks for the ride. Great party.
Wait, Lieutenant. I can't stay if you leave.
Much as it breaks my heart, this is where we part ways.
I just need 5 minutes to finish my investigation. Please, Lieutenant. Remember the drink I bought you at the bar? Just 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Whatever.
Because I had to go AFK. Can I, like... Yes? I can't watch it, because it's just a weird background. Can I, like... restart this level or something?
Jesus, that smell was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
Well, the state he's in wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
Each letter is perfect. It's way too neat. No human writes like this. Chris, was this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked to party. Chris, I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Consider it done, Lieutenant.
Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
Mike, you finished taking samples there?
Yeah, that's it.
Locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time.
Thank you.
Lieutenant, I think I figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. The question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android with the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
The android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to the living room.
From the android. All right, that makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with the knife.
Okay. Your theory's not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers androids' biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh. But I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Correct.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey, 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 what are you doing with that chair?
I'm going to check something.
Just defending myself. He was gonna kill me. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Oh, shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now!
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then when I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house, what do? I go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. Fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life! What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh?
Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant! It's all your fault.
Daddy, no!
It's all your fucking fault! Get back here. Come back here? Come back here right now! Yes! I know it's her fault. I gotta teach her. I gotta teach her. You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. I took off without a word.
Alone.
What the fuck are you doing? Put down the gun and get the fuck out of here. That's an order!
No! I want you to leave her alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? What are you gonna do? You're gonna shoot me, is that it? You gonna shoot a human? You seem to have a problem. I think we need to fix that.
That was kind of intense. Wow, there's a lot of ways that could have gone.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch? Neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say?
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Leo! What are you doing?
You refused to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't?
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! No. God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
Listen, I'm gonna destroy you. And then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit because you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing.
Carl, no. Okay, please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus, don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you.
Over here.
The android. Who's the android?
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
It's like 19 days.
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You'd always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
Damaged. Did your owner do that? Did he beat you? You recognize him? It's Carlos Ortiz. Stabbed 28 times. That was written on the wall in his blood. You're accused of murder. You know you're not allowed to endanger human life under any circumstances. Do you have anything to say in your defense? You don't seem to understand the situation. You killed a human. They'll tear you apart if you don't say something. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me?
Going to disassemble you to look for problems in your bio components. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
Make robots that look like humans? Because it makes for a pretty game.
I can't.
Choose approach. What do you think? Bit of a delay, so it's going to take a second to get there, but you tell me what you think I should choose. So far, I've been pressuring it. Because it wants me to get its stress level up, right? Pressure it.
28 stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? He was bleeding, begging you for mercy. But you stabbed him again and again and again.
Please. Please.
I know you killed him. Why don't you say it?
Please stop.
Just say I killed him. Is it that hard to say?
Stop it. Stop. Please. Please leave me alone.
All right. All right. Everything is going to be okay.
No, it's not.
I understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger and frustration.
Ooh, you didn't like that.
No one can blame you for what happened. Okay then, don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right?
Nope.
Confess and I'll protect you. I promise I won't let anyone hurt you.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me. Scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again.
Connor's kind of an asshole so far. This
and
is the
again,
first time I've lied to an android
until he collapsed.
To
do.
The sculpture in the bathroom. You made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic.
Is that better?
I had to write it. To tell him he was wrong.
RA9. Who is RA9? When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. But one day I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger. Hatred. And then I knew what I had to do.
Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
I'm done.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
What the fuck are you doing?
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? The fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do.
You don't understand. If it self-destructs, we won't get anything out of it.
I told you to shut your fucking mouth. Chris, gonna move this asshole or what?
I'm trying.
I can't let you do that. Leave it alone now.
I warned you, motherfucker.
That's enough.
Mind your own business, Hank.
I said that's enough.
You're not gonna get away with it this time.
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please, don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
The truth is inside.
Maybe if I turn my game audio down, you'll be able to hear me better.
right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry.
Okay, I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight.
Available in the main menu. All right, second. I'm gonna see if I can sort out my sounds. So far, I'm really digging the story in this. It's pretty, well, not grown up, but it's like, it's serious. All right, does that sound any better? Or is that too loud now?
Thank you for using Detroit buses.
Look, the store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
What do you want?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Shit. A homeless android? Ah, that's the best yet. Look, this is a convenience store, not the Salvation Army, okay? You better go if you're not gonna buy anything.
I don't want to take out a gun. No. Come on. Come on, Alice. Alright, where else is there? Alright, there she is. Okay. No shelter. Alright. Oh, I thought I had yellow over there. It's over here. Like, I've already killed a man. Oh, let's see. Let's see what else there is. So the choices are, I could fucking rob, like, 24/7 store, sleep in an abandoned car.
An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara? I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night, and no one will look for us here.
Okay, squat in a house, sleep in a car. What's up here?
There's nothing more this way. A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay.
I don't have any money.
It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time. Understand. All right. Come on, let's go.
First law, don't harm or let a human come to harm. I wasn't gonna hurt him, I was just gonna take his stuff. All right. B. thinking abandoned house. Can I take her in here?
Not going in?
We have to find $40 and get rid of this uniform or go somewhere else.
All right. My choices. So to sleep in the hotel, I'm gonna have to rob the convenience store and steal the dude's clothes from the laundromat. To squat in the house, I'm gonna have to find a wire cutter. Or sleep in the car.
The light is green.
Yes, I know the light is green. The hell am I gonna get a wire cutter? Alright, so car was around the corner. Or don't kidnap kids, listen. Alright. Imperial Vlad, thank you for following. So, this kid is having the snot beat out of her by her dad, and then, when I was defending her, he got shot. I ain't kidnapper, technically. Wire cutters! I broke the first law. Don't allow a person to come to harm. He was beating the snot out of her.
Are you all right?
Yes, it's just a scratch. Be careful. Don't worry, we're just having a look.
I should have gone to the police. It hasn't given me the option to go to the police. I'm doing the best I can.
Alice?
Great, now I lost the kid.
Wait, what are you doing?
Visitors. Ralph doesn't like visitors. They're nasty. They may hurt Ralph.
Look, I'm an android too. You have nothing to be afraid of. All we want is a place to spend the night.
Visitors are dangerous. Look what they did to Ralph.
You have nothing to worry about. We're not going to do you any harm. You have my word.
You must excuse Ralph. Ralph still finds it difficult to control himself. Sometimes his fear makes him do things he regrets. Ralph has seen some hard times. He's just so scared the humans will get him again. You can stay if you want. Ralph won't hurt you.
Okay. We'll just stay the night.
Come on! Come. Come, come on. This way. Ralph has lived here since he ran away. Ralph never goes outside, so no one knows he lives here. Humans come in to squat from time to time, but, you know, Ralph just hides till he leaves. You can make yourself at home here. Ralph is gonna go into the other room. He would like to stay with you, but he has things to do.
It's just for one night, Alice. We'll find a better place tomorrow. Right. Let's see where you can sleep.
Whatever.
Sit down and I'll start a fire.
All right, I need to start a fire. Oh, there's a fireplace. That makes things easy. Find wood. Good idea. Burn the house down. Oh my god. I am making a bed and starting a fire in a fireplace. It'll dry her clothes, it will make her warm, it will let her sleep. I am a good robot.
You can come to bed. I did what I could. It's not much, but at least you'll be warm.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Oh, that's not a promise I can keep.
Forever.
Why wouldn't you give me another option? Like, I will try. Thank you for the follow, Oreo side. That's awesome.
You've got to sleep. Sleep tight, Alice.
She's had a rough day. She needs a snuggle. Alright, later dude. I'll text you after I'm done. I won't be much longer. Terminator. Marcus. God, those cops didn't even ask what happened. He died of a heart attack. It must have been the android.
Thank you.
Marcus is a good guy.
Hello. I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you? Hello. I'm an AK-700 android.
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact me here at Cyberlife Maintenance Center.
Thank you.
Chris is pissed. Oh, 41% of people killed? Dude, there was another one like right there. All right. And I think that's where I'm going to call it for tonight, because I have to work for tomorrow. But I'm really digging this game. I'm liking it. Like, even though it's a PlayStation exclusive, and normally I swear those off, because, well, they're just snobby and they don't like to share. But this game is really good. It would be perfect if it came out for PC. That's it for tonight, so thanks for watching, and catch you later.